Hey, it's Paul Jang, and today we're going to be talking about land investing, young living. Excuse me. All right, so question is basically, can I live overseas or live in a car by investing in land? So if you want to, you know, go out into the world and live an adventurous life, is that possible kind of on the road? Now, here's the thing with land investing. And this is basically going to sum up land investing in a nutshell. All you have to do is get deals and then market those deals and sell it. That is the whole business, right? In both of those steps, I'll just kind of show you that you can do this kind of on the road. If you want to be overseas or if you want to go ahead and live in a car, like you can go ahead and do that. Like you can fit this business model with whatever lifestyle you're living. If you're overseas or on the road, basically to get deals, the easiest way to do it is to send mailers out. Some people like to do, just get feelers out and send out a bunch of mail. But I found that the best way to do it is to send out a blind offer. And it just takes away a lot of the negotiation you might have. You know, you're just buying it at the price that you feel comfortable buying it, and that's kind of it. There will be some people that might want a counter offer on it, but I don't even give that option. It's like, here, take it or leave it, and then I just kind of move on. But there's mailing companies like Offers to Owners, Click to Mail, Rocket Mail, or you could even print out your own mail and then send it out. I essentially get offers back through email or through calls. Some people like to send it through the mail, but there's even like digital companies, digital like mailing companies that will scan all of your documents and forward it to wherever you want it to go if you're on the road. Basically, that kind of solves the majority of just like finding deals in real estate land with houses and commercial property. That's just not as feasible. Especially if you're overseas and you're on the road and you're buying a place sight unseen, it's a lot more difficult to do that because you're gonna want to know like damages or, you know, what's the condition of the property. Whereas land, that's not really an issue. All of these land deals can be done through Google Maps and different software to kind of locate the property. Now, that kind of handles the first part of land investing in a nutshell. Finding deals and marketing them. Now for marketing them, you'll almost always use the internet. Now you could do yard signs and hire someone to put them out, but the easiest way to do it is land listing sites. Like land.com has three, LandWatch, Lands of America, and Lands and Farm. But there's also Facebook Marketplace. Within Facebook, there's also groups that you can post your property in and get potential deals. You can also, I don't know if I said Craigslist. Craigslist is still a popular way to get deals. Another way you can go about it is you can find discount MLS services. And as long as you put like a couple thousand dollars within the commission, like you can find realtors that might present your property for their prospective buyers. Now, I'm not going to say that the MLS is the strongest place to list and sell your land. But it is an option if you kind of want your property to be kind of omnipresent, like in all different parts. Here's the fourth thing that you're gonna need to do when you're thinking about this. It's the title company. So when you are working with the title company, they're basically gonna be able to do all the paperwork for you. And I like to use title companies for larger deals. When I say larger, you know, I'm talking about like $5,000 and more. And what this allows us to do is basically they'll send down a mobile notary over to your location, and you just get all the paperwork signed, and then whoever's buying or selling the land wires the funds to the title company, and that's kind of it, and you just move on. If you're overseas, you might have to work with the commissary or the consulate, because some overseas, when you're overseas, some of the countries don't have notaries, but that would be an option if you have to go to like a consulate and just get those papers signed. But the title company will have those options and the ability to close on those properties for you if you're using their services. And that's basically it in a nutshell. Can you live overseas or, you know, live in a car and kind of on the go while being in the, you know, land investing world? Yeah, like live your young life. Live like the way you want to live. You can definitely do it, okay? Oh, by the way, if you like building multiple streams of income and you want to see different ways you can build your wealth and you know, if that's you, subscribe and like this video. It helps us out with the YouTube algorithm and it'll forward you more content, you know, like this. Take care. Have a good one.